Mason is an interesting guy. He's a adventurous spirit, I mean, to say the least, if you're in his line of work. So he's someone who is obviously a driven person and someone who always likes to come out on top. I think that drives him through the whole movie, and he just wants to better himself, but sometimes he doesn't know exactly what better is. And I think he searches for that, and I think hopefully finds it. But who's to say? My kind of backstory for Mason, I like the idea that he was always striving for an older father figure in Devereaux, and I think also you see that in his interactions with Hanley and Weinstein at times, you know, be it adoration or be it a want to kind of rebel or show his worth to them. I think from what I kind of worked out with Mason was that he was maybe an orphan at a young age, and you know, that gave him the ability to be able to drop things and not be attached to anything, and you know, you mustn't have any, you know, real grabs. I mean, he still struggles with it. He's still human in the end. He's not a Manchurian candidate at all. And I think, you know, what the film does delve into is the idea of taking orders, but also making decisions and adapting and choosing one's own path at a point. I did some training with some members of the Special Forces here, actually, in terms of arms training, which was a thrill for me. I haven't done anything like that. You know, I've only really shot a rifle on a mate's farm back in Australia, you know, and done nothing military-wise, but it was great to learn all the ins and outs of that. And so it was obviously safety first, and that was the first priority, but all the different techniques, clearing a room, stuff like that, shooting techniques, and all that, it's been just an absolute ball. Also the fighting with the stunt guys, all the fight coordinations, it's been great.
Devereaux, Pierce's character, is this kind of seasoned, the baddest of the bad kind of guy, and I'm this kind of young upstart that he takes on as in this mentoring kind of role for me, and preaches all the things that he thinks is essential to make it as an agent. One of the most important was having no attachments, knowing that you are on the clock 24/7, you are constantly working, and to have any real human relationship in contact, that's putting not only yourself in danger, but those people that you're potentially loving. So yeah, it's a real interesting story between duty and want and purpose and need. There's just a professionalism that I really wanted to take from him, and I feel I absorbed and learned a lot in terms of being professional on set, and I really appreciated that. Every kind of bit of advice he gave me, I tried to take it on and lock it away, and it was really, really a treat for me. A very, very special gift. I couldn't put down the script when I first read it. It is a high octane, absolute thrill ride with some, you know, some real interesting conspiracies going on. And I think in, you know, today we're a little skeptical of a lot of things that go on in, you know, Eastern Europe and also in this country and all around the world. You know, no one can really trust the higher ups, I think, and everyone's a little dubious about what they hear on the news and in the newspapers and on the telly and stuff like that. So I think that kind of that dose of conspiracy and espionage and mixed with the absolute thrill of fist combat and guns and blowing up cars and chases and stuff like that and all the technology involved. I think it's a real fun, great movie, a great hark back to those awesome action movies of the 90s. Where you went and there were consequences and there's high stakes and it's kind of full throttle the whole way. And I think people are gonna really enjoy it for that. I really enjoyed it for that. For me, the story was thoroughly engrossing. I loved it.